Does your company buy and sell items whose unit of measure is not on the QuickBooks list? Well, then you need to learn how to set up a custom unit using the count unit in QuickBooks. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Custom units, which QuickBooks calls count units, is a unit of measure that you use that's not on the preset list of units of measure. For example, if you sell beer, you could sell either a can or a six-pack. And when you buy the beer from the supplier, there's approximately 4 six-packs in a crate. In this case, you must tell QuickBooks the math relationship between the different units of measure that you buy and sell the merchandise in. It will then do the math conversion for you when you change from one unit to the next. That's the beautiful thing about using unit of measure in QuickBooks. So the base unit is, as we know, the unit of measure that the sales price and purchase cost will be based on. So if we know the can is the base unit, we have to know the purchase cost and determine a sales price per can. We obviously know that there are 6 cans in a six pack, but we also have to determine how many six packs in a crate and how many cans are in a crate. Well, it's very simple if we're selling beer. We know that if we sell by can, that there are 6 cans in a six pack. So we could buy and sell the individual cans or buy and sell them in six packs. And in this example, there are 4 six-packs to the crate that it comes in when we buy it by crate from our supplier. So we therefore would have to tell QuickBooks how many cans are in a crate. And in this example, there would be 24 cans in a crate because in America, 6 times 4 is 24. So let's add beer to the items list in QuickBooks. And here's all the information you need. We'll imagine we're purchasing it at 50 cents each can. And we'll imagine that we sell each can in the deli for $2 each. The purchase unit, or the unit that we actually purchase it in from the supplier, is a crate. And we will use the same sales account and cost of goods sold account as all the other inventory items that we have been using in this video series. The abbreviation for the cans will be CN when we create our custom unit of measure. So, how do we do that? Well, here we are in QuickBooks, and let's just remember this information. From the main menu, we click List, Item List, and let's stretch it taller a little. From the bottom left, we click Item, New. Now, this is an inventory part, and the name will be Beer, not the denomination, the name of the item. Of course, we purchase it for 50 cents each, 50 cents each can. Remember, this is the purchase cost of the smallest denomination, the base unit. And we use the cost of goods sold account. The sales price is $2 each can. And we use the same sales income account that we used for the other inventory. Now, when it comes to unit of measure, we have to click Add New. And if it's custom, we choose Other. Other unit of measure and click Next. Now, the name will be can, because again, the first one you put is the base unit, the smallest denomination that the purchase cost and sales price will be based on. Can. And the abbreviation, capital C, capital N. Then click Next. Now, we have to add related units. So we're going to add the name six pack. I like to type in the word six so it doesn't get confused with the quantity. And the abbreviation is SXPK, six pack. And then obviously there are six cans in a six pack. And we will add crate. And the abbreviation CRT, whatever. And there are how many? Now, notice what it's asking. It's not asking us how many six packs are in a crate. Look what happened up here once we defined the first row. It's asking us how many cans in a crate. And in America, that would be 24. And then we click Next. Now, we purchase it by the crate usually, but we will have the ability to change that if we're only purchasing six packs. And we sell it by can, and we could sell it by six pack, but these are the defaults. We can sell them at we can change them at the moment we make the transaction, but these are the defaults, and you can leave shipping the same as the purchase for now. Click Next. And then name of the unit of measure, set the name, the base unit or any related units. Let's just call this beer cans. The overall name of these units. And then we click Finish. And then, of course, now that we're done setting up the unit of measure, we can click OK, and beer is on the list, ready for us to buy and sell in the units of measure that we set up. And now, let's purchase some beer with the intention of selling it to the customer. Let's imagine on March 1, we paid Addie's Orchard immediately for 8 crates. Remember, it's 50 cents per can purchased, and there are 24 cans in a crate, and we're buying 8 crates. So that's 192 cans. And 192 cans at 50 cents a can is equal to $96. And that's the amount that QuickBooks should calculate for us when we write this check. From the main menu, click Banking, write a check. The date should be March 1 of 2019. And we purchased it from Addie's Orchard. And no, we're not using a previous purchase order. And yes, we're going to continue to write a check. Now, click the pull down arrow, and we're going to find our beer. Now, notice it remembers the unit is a crate, and a crate, one crate should be $12 if there are 24 cans at 50 cents each. However, we're going to change the quantity to 8 crates, which means we're actually paying $96 for 192 cans that are in that crate. Now, when we click Save and Close, we can look at the inventory valuation detail. Oh, let's look at the good one here. Inventory valuation detail, go down to beer. Now we have how many? We have 192 on hand, and we paid $96. Here's the unit of measure abbreviation, 50 cents each. Now we'll sell the cans of beer. Let's imagine on March 2nd, 2019, we sold 5 cans to Candy Charles Cash Today. Well, if it's one can is $2 and we're selling 5, that means $10 is the sales income from this sale to Candy. And $2.50 is what we paid for the 5 cans that we are now giving Candy. So, oh, let's go back. Okay, so let's go ahead and sell 5 cans to Candy on March 2nd. We open up sale receipt, and the date is March 2nd. And the customer we're selling to is Candy. Now, the item is beer. And QuickBooks remembers that the unit, the default unit of sale is the can. So what we have here now is one can, but we actually sold five cans. And if we sold five cans, that means that the income will be $10 and the cost of goods sold will be $2.50. Click Save and Close, and now you can see we have 10, oh here, wait, where the beer? Right, we have five fewer cans on hand, and if you look at the trial balance, and then you go to the cost of goods sold account, double click, the very last sale, the cost of what we paid in the cost of goods sold, what we paid for those five cans that we gave to Candy on March 2nd was $2.50. And the sales income that we earned, which is somewhere around here, yeah, in the very last sale was $10, exactly as we expected. Now let's sell in a different unit of measure. Let's imagine on March 4th, we sold 2 6-packs to Betty. So if it's $2 a can as the sales price, 12 cans and 2 6-packs equals $24. And of course, what we paid for those 2 6-packs would be $6 because it's 50 cents each can that we bought it for. Please note, if you are changing the unit of measure in which you sell, you must click Change, not Convert. And I will show you what I mean. After you click Change, then you change the unit of measure, then physically go and change the quantity. You have to be careful as you do it because the window can be tricky. So watch how we make this sale. We open the sales receipt and we're selling to Betty and we're selling on March 4th, whatever, and we're selling beer. Now originally it will come up as a can. Now, when we click the pull-down arrow for unit of measure, do not click convert. If you click convert, the money amount will stay the same. It will simply display it differently in the window. But we want to change one can to 1 6-pack. Once you change the unit of measure, then you see the money amounts change. Now, after you change the unit of measure, then you can change the quantity. So it knows we're selling 6-packs, and now it knows we're selling 2 6-packs, and now we have the correct money amount for the sale. So we know it's $24 for the sales income and $6 for the cost of goods sold. Save and close, and we open the trial balance, and when we go to sales, the very last sale was $24 in income. And if we open cost of goods sold, which is what we paid, and we look at the very last sale, we paid $6 for the beer that Candy gave us $24 for. Yeah, don't tell her. Okay, but that's how it works. And now we're at the most important part of this lesson. Selling a six-pack for less than $12 or selling a crate for less than $48. In other words, we give the customer a break if they make what's commonly called a bulk purchase. How do you do this? Well, there are important things to note for bulk sales. Must change the unit of measure first, then change the quantity, just like we did a moment ago. You must select Change, not Convert. Convert just gives you a different number that it displays, but it doesn't really change the price or the money amount. You have to change the unit of measure and then change the quantity. Then after that, after you're all set the way you normally would, after you change both of those things, then change the sales price of the bulk unit, not the base unit, because the bulk unit will be the one displayed after you changed it. So then the cost of goods sold will be the same for the sale, only the sales income and gross profit will be a little bit lower because you sold it to them in bulk. You didn't buy them for less because you sold them in bulk. So the cost of goods sold will be the same, but the sales income will be slightly different because you gave them a break on a bulk purchase. So here's our example. So here's the example of our bulk sale. On March 6th, we sold 4 6-packs for $10 each to Alan. Sales will increase by $40 because that's the income that Alan gave us. The cost of goods sold will still be $12 because that's what we paid for the 24 cans in the 6-packs that we're giving to Alan. We open the sale receipt window. We choose March 6th of 2019. And we choose customer Alan. Now, the item that we're selling is beer. And notice it comes up in cans. So we first change the unit to 6-packs. And QuickBooks assumes they're $12 each. We then change the quantity to 4. Now, normally, it would be $48 for 4 6-packs because it's $2 a can. But we're giving him 4 6-packs for $40 instead. So we overtype 40. That will automatically adjust the rate. You could have adjusted the rate to 10 for each of the 6-packs, and the total would be calculated as 40. Click Save and Close, and you can see in the trial balance in the sales account when we double-click, the last sale on March 6th had sales income of just $40 because that's what we charged Alan. But the cost of goods sold, if we double-click and look at this very last sale on March 6th, the cost of goods sold is still $12 because that's what we paid for the 4 6-packs that we just gave to Alan.